Hello everyone, I'm fine that you have clicked into this video. I want to lay down my idea of how a transmitter for RC models can be designed regarding its software. This is the experimental platform I'm using right now. It has mounted to all gimbals from a previous transmitter, and I have a numeric display. At the moment I don't have a graphic display because it would consume more time to write the software for that, and I don't really need it. For the rest of the video, I'm going to disappear from the screen and step into a short PowerPoint presentation of around 10 minutes. The slides are made up very simple, but they will contain the basic information I want to reflect. And after that, I'm going to give a short live demonstration of the transmitter, of what I've implemented until now. And that will be also around 10 minutes.
So this is the content of the PowerPoint presentation. And it consists on 6 points. The first one is I'm going to show state of the art of the radio transmitters. The second is I'll give an example which is based on the state of the art. In the third point I'm going to pin out the changes I want to do. In the point 4 I'm going to give an example which is based on the changes and deals around the same topic like in point 2. To make it comparable. And point 5 shows the organigram of the transmitter, and 4.6 I'm going to step out of the PowerPoint presentation and give a little live demonstration of what I've implemented until now and to show the way it's going to work. So this is the state of the art. It shows the signal flow. It's you can see there's a joystick and it's connected to a calculation pipe, and this for itself is connected to the output. In the calculation pipe you most often have functions like inverting the signal, scaling it, and maybe different things, giving it an offset. And the output is a servo, ESC or lamp or whatever. And this structure is mostly very fixed, you can't really change it. And I'm going to give this example, and I want to assume that I want to fly in a plane, and I want to use the ailerons also as flaps, so I need some kind of mixer. And most often it's working the way that you're going to your menu and there's a submenu which deals around mixers, and then you say okay, I want to use flaps, and I want to change already this. And of course this makes it kind of easy that you simply can say I want to use flaps, but on the other hand this narrows down your options because you're just working on a predefined setup you can enable or disable, and this makes your options smaller. So the structure is that you have this calculation pipe, then you have a joystick for the ailerons and a switch for the flaps. And in this calculation pipe these two signals are coupled with each other, and then they are forwarded to outputs which will be servos in the wings from the plane. So I'm going to pin out the changes. The first one will be the connections from the inputs to the calculation pipe, then the appearance from the calculation pipe itself, and the third will be I want to define the connections from calculation pipe to output. So this is the new approach, and as you can already see that the appearance of the calculation pipe differs. I'm trying to symbolize it by these triangles. They show that the calculation pipe isn't a monolithic block anymore. It rather consists of modules you can snap in like in a puzzle, so you can adjust it to the needs. The first module will always be that you type in a number, and this number selects which input the channel is going to use. For example, the inputs are simply arranged in a row, so the number just defines which member of the row is going to be taken for the channel. And the outputs, they are carrying a list of the channels they should be sensitive to. And here you could ask why I'm doing it this way, and the simple answer is in the beginning you mostly don't know to how many outputs a channel is connected to. And so, for example, you can say, okay, the last module of a channel would be that I type in a number from the output I wanted to send its value to. In the end, you never know if it's one output, two output, or maybe there's a crazy idea and you want to assign it to 5 outputs. And this is the reason why I'm going to make it the way that the output carries a list of the channel it's sensitive to. Okay, I'm coming to the second example with the same topic, aileron and flap mixing. And as you can already see, I have 2 channels for this idea, and each channel is connected to each output. On the first side, it might look more complicated, and actually for this simple design it is. But once you come to the idea, okay, I want to have a slow movement for the flaps and I don't want to flip them out all of a sudden when I switch the button, then you need a module which is dependent to the time. And so of course the behavior from the channel for the switch button differs from the channel from the joystick. So of course you need a second pipe. And the next idea could be, okay, when I'm bringing out the flaps, I also want to bring out the landing gear, but maybe with a different behavior. So I need a second channel which is sensitive to the same switch, but acts on a different output. And the next idea could be, maybe you want to change something with a switch in the behavior of the ailerons. And the last idea could be, okay, when I'm coming in for landing with the plane and bringing out the flaps and the landing gear, I want to scale down the movement from the ailerons to make the movement from the plane a little less aggressive. So it could be possible that you assign the same switch to act on a output directly and also use it just for inner purposes. Okay, I'm going to show which kind of knowledge and toolset I'm using. I'm started with a book for C# to get some practice in object-oriented programming, and then I proceeded with a microcontroller STM32 because it's possible to program then in C++, and object-oriented programming gives me most of the options I need to fulfill my idea for the points of changes I've mentioned before. I'm using a Kyle Microvision compiler, and for the first beginning I did my investigations based on this toolset, and it was good to learn and kind of interesting. And after a while I was stuck in some problems I really couldn't solve, and then I came to this book, which is dealing around design patterns, and it gives you hints how problems are solved which are appearing very often. And it's not dealing directly with a specific programming language, rather than giving ideas how to do something in principle. And this book helped me out of my problems very much. Some of the solutions you can't use directly on embedded systems, because this book assumes that you're working on a real computer and using C# or Java or something like that. Not everything is possible to use in embedded systems under C++, but nevertheless it helped me very much. Okay, now I'm coming to the object structure, or we can say organigram, of the transmitter. And as you can see on the left side, there are the outputs. They are all arranged in a list, and each output points to a list of channels, and each channel for itself points to the calculation model it uses. The idea is, when an output is told to work, then it's forwarding this this command to the a channel, and each channel forwards this command to the calculation modules. And for example, this output tells this channel to run, then the channel is iterating through the calculation modules, and in the end it retrieves a value which is then feedback to the output. And this is where the object-oriented programming comes into the game. All these calculation modules are implementing a a specific interface, so the channel doesn't even have to know which calculation model it uses, it just has to know how to use them. And the same is true for the outputs, it doesn't even have to know which kind of channels there are. It could be analog channels or digital channels or maybe something I haven't even think of until today, and it just needs to know how to use them. And yeah, the last slide, I'm going to show how it's possible to change the appearance of a channel and change the organization of the modules. For example, when you want to change or want to add a calculation module, it works in a way that the specific channel sends a request to something I call a module factory, and then the module factory offers some modules which are useful for a channel. For example, there can be different modules for analog and digital channels. And then after a request, the produced module is sent back to the list and coupled to it. Yeah, and this is the way you can change the appearance of the calculation modules list. Okay, this was the last slide of the PowerPoint presentation. I'm going to step out from the presentation and give a short live demonstration of what I've implemented until now. Okay, see you then. Bye. So this is the live demonstration. We have here a simple setup of four servos. There are two big ones, this on the left and on the right. They could be the one in the wings for the ailerons and flaps. And here's a small one which could be the rudder, and there's a number four in mounted in this wing. Okay, for the first I'm going to configure the transmitter to according to the example with aileron and flap mixing. So I'm going to the configs and setting up two analog calculation pipes, and then I'm going to the configs, the analog configs, and as we can see we have two channels here, and on the right top here you can see there's a name. At the moment it's just the numbers, and this will become a little bit confusing when you have set up too many channels and they are just iterated by numbers. So I'm going to assign a name, but I won't write it completely, just the first letter for not consuming too much time on this. Okay, I'm choosing the first letter and I'm giving it number A for aileron, and stepping out from there. That was one too far. Now I'm going to the second channel, assigning a name, and this is going to be the flaps. So I'm going to choose an F for the first letter, like this. Okay. Now I'm making them sensitive to the correct joystick. I have written some numbers on these stickers to know for which analog input a joystick is connected to. And the flaps, I'm going to assign the flaps to this, so it's going to be the number one, like it's already written in. And for the ailerons, I'm going to assign it to the fourth input, so they should be sensitive to this one. I'm going to channel select, and I'm increasing it to number four. Okay, now I'm going out, and now I have to assign these analog channels to an output, so I'm going to assign source. And here I'm choosing add analog source. Okay, here we have the ailerons. You can see on the top. Yeah, now if I'm already mounted it to an output, as you can see the servo is moving, but it's only one. So I have to assign the aileron also on the second servo, which is there. It's connected to the number two from the receiver, like this. And now there are both of them are moving. Okay, for the flaps it's similar but not the same. We will see it. I'm going to F for flaps, assigning it to the second and the first, like this. Okay, now they're also moving, but they're also moving similar in the same direction. but on this one I want to move them vice versa. So I'm going out from adding a source, going to configuring it. So we have the output number one here, and I'm going to change the direction of one of the servos. Okay, here we have the second channel. Yeah, this is still a little confusing. I have to write here the name, I have to change it in the source code, of course. And I'm going to change the sign here. You can see it when I'm pushing the button, it changes. For one of them I'm going to change it. And now they're moving vice versa on this joystick and moving in the same direction on this stick. Okay, this was the example. And now I'm going to set up the side rudder, which is this small servo. So I'm going to analog and once again setting up a next calculation pipe, going to configs, and now there's a third channel, as you can see. I'm assigning a name to it as well, naming it, giving it an R for rudder, like this, and I'm going to assign it to input number 3, like this. Okay, stepping out, assigning the source, add analog channel, choosing number 3, the rudder, and this one is connected to the receiver's output number 6. So I'm going to out number 6, entering it, and now it's moving. And now this is where it's becoming interesting. I want to set up the next mixer. For example, my left thumb is not smart enough to control two channels independent from each other, so I want to have a mixer from the ailerons on the side rudder, but I want to have it with a different scaling. So I want the side rudder reacting with a smaller scaling to this joystick than the ailerons are sensitive to it. So that's why I need another analog calculation pipe. I've set up next one, and now we have 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Assigning a name, I'm calling it RR for rudder aileron. No, that was one too far. Configs, assign name, like this, and error, okay, like this. And as I said, I want the side rudder to be sensitive to the joystick from the aileron, which is this. So I'm going to give it a channel selection, the input selection number 4, like this. But as I mentioned, I want to have it with a different scaling. But at the moment we can see, no, that was the wrong button. At the moment we can see there's only the module factory, assigning a name, channel selection, and then it starts from the beginning again. So I'm going to the module factory, and here I'm choosing the scale. Now I'm entering it, and now we have module factory, assigning a name, channel selection. Now we have a scale left and a scale right. So you see the menu has changed, and it's only the menu depth is only as deep as you need it. So, okay, I'm going to decrease it from 50% to 30% for the left, and the same for the right, like this, and now I'm stepping out, and once again I have to assign it, assign a source, add another source. Here we have the rudder aileron, and I'm assigning it to the rudder servo, which have been on the 6. I'm entering it, and now the rudder is also sensitive to the aileron joystick. I can control it I can control it in single mode on this joystick, and in conjunction with the ailerons on this joystick if I want to. Okay, yeah. And yeah, for example, I could also go ahead and putting the elevator on this stick. Oh, looks like I've already made it, and as you can... Oh no, this have been the flaps, of course. This was the simulation for the flaps. Here we have the ailerons, side rudder, and I want to put the elevator on this one. So I'm going to analog a second time, new analog pipe. Now we have five channels, assigning a name, giving it a name of elevator, calling it E, like this, stepping out, assign a source, add the analog source, we have the elevator, and this is on output number 4. No, it's not. It should be. I guess it's... yeah. I forgot something. I forgot to change the analog input selection. So I'm going to analog again to the configurations, choosing the elevator, and yeah, here it is. It's still written to number 1, which is this input number 1, but I want it to be sensitive to number 2. No, wrong. Yeah, like this. Now everything is correct. This is the way I wanted it to be. Okay, this was yeah, an example configuration for the transmitter, and the next things I have to think about is to do the source code for digital inputs like these switches, and yeah, and of course saving settings and restoring settings is something I've already done some investigations on. It I just have to write the source code. Okay, I hope I see you in the video which is coming next, and okay, see you, bye.